play, praise, pray. The three P's. It's a little bit of a mouthful, but you know, I like to change things around and I don't like 3P as the third party. So we're going to make it play, praise, pray. What exactly is that? Couples that play together, stay together. Couples that pray together, stay together. But if you praise your partner, you praise your relationship, you praise the quality of your relationship, you're also going to stay together. Let's think about this. You play together. So you go out and it's wintertime in some parts of the world and you make a snowman and you have fun, you're laughing, you're joking, and you have a great time. You're doing something together that is fun. People who have fun with somebody want to stay with that person. We've all heard in the church, couples that pray together stay together. Well, that is true, but not for the way the church teaches it only. If you're praying together, that means you are coming together as one and you are raising whatever your relationship is up, not just the church. You're also raising your relationship up. So if I am praying for the health of my partner, the wealth of my partner, that my partner is fun and romantic, and I turn my prayer into a thank you for this amazing partner, thank you for this amazing relationship, thank you for this amazing life, then I'm praying with my partner. Now, how do I praise my partner? Well, you know, that's the easy one. You did a great job. So proud of you, honey. You know you don't like this job, but I'm really proud of you for getting up and going and doing it while you're looking for another job. You know, I understand I've been going through a difficult time. Thank you for supporting me. Honey, I need to vent. Oh, thank you for listening to me. There's also the, when you get into the car with them and you're going out for a date night, because you know, we have to have date nights now. Back then it was just mom and dad going out for dinner to get away from the kids. But today it's couples have to have date night. Do you ever get in the car and just start the night with, just in case I forget to tell you later, I had a great time? These things truly transform your relationship so that you have an amazing relationship. Bonus, if you do this in the beginning of your relationship, all the way through your relationship, it will never end. I talk about it all the time. You have to affirm. You're already affirming 86,400 seconds a day. So what are you affirming? Play, praise, and pray gives you the option of affirming for what you want in a focus forward direction. So you're using two out of my three laws right here. Focus forward, and the law of one consciousness. So if you use the law of one, which is you're talking about it out loud, so you're telling your girlfriend, oh, what a wonderful person this man is. You're telling your guy friends, oh my God, I found a really good one. She's a gem. She's so supportive, loving. I mean, she respects me. She appreciates me. We can have deep conversations, difficult conversations in a loving way. What are you going to get? You're going to get love in return. Our love language, everybody says, oh, we all have these love languages. But everyone will say this, respect. Respect is the number one thing in a love language. Showing your partner respect. Number two is making them feel important. So you have respect and making them feel important. If they're important and you're in the middle of an emergency, you're going to stop when you get a moment and message them. If they don't feel important, then they're going to sit there and tell these awful stories about being ghosted. So your partner died. But first, this is Susie, your beautiful swan queen. Welcome back to Discover Your Inner Royalty with the King's Incredible Daughter. I am the best life coach with a 99.6% success rate in helping people get together with the love of their life. When you're ready to coach with me, you want to join my paid Facebook group, Upscale Your Money. Those links are in the description below. I have this amazing No Negative Stories program. I do cover it, Discover, I do call it Discover Your Inner Royalty. Because when you let go of the negative stories, all of a sudden you feel internally like a king or a queen, an empress, a duchess, a lady. You feel completely different. I got a message from somebody and they said they wrote 4 pages of a negative story that they had about on one of the lessons. And each lesson that they have done since then makes them feel even better. I've had people who have gone through this once and now they're doing it a second time on a specific situation in their life. So you go through it on a base. Let's clear the negative general stories that we're running. Well, now you have a health issue. Let's go through it a second time and clear your health issue. What is holding you back? Writing it out is the best way to figure it out, because we don't really tell everything to everybody. We bottle a lot in. So when you're interested in letting go of that negative story, the link is in the description below to clear your negative stories so you feel truly, truly royal. So let's get back to this. Your specific person ghosted you and you're running around telling everybody, and you're going to tarot card readings and you're doing spells and you're talking to your friends. He ghosted me. She ghosted me. Ghost, 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 ghost. You're literally making them a ghost because of the one consciousness. What you're telling everybody, ghost, 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 ghost. They're leaving you. Your other side of your couch is empty. People wonder, why do I sit on one side of the couch? Well, if my specific person was here, they'd be sitting there. If my daughter was here, she'd be sitting there. I don't just take one side of the couch. I'm actually in the middle, if people don't realize, but there's room for others. So I can invite you in. We can have a conversation. But when we're having that conversation, how much of what you actually tell me in coaching is the whole story? Because I get it all the time. Oh, Susie, I can't talk about the negative. Well, you can't talk about the negative. All right, fine. But how are you praising your partner? What good things are you telling your friends, your family, your coworkers, the strangers? You go up to the register to check out and somebody notices you have tears in your eyes. I'm going to say, you okay? You doing okay today? And a lot of times they're going to say, yeah, I'm fine. And other times they're going to be like, no, I'm fighting with my spouse. And they're such an idiot. Like, they just don't get it. Like, they're so mean to me. Guys, that's why they're mean to you. Because your praise is the negative story. It is what you don't want. And then your play, you live for. You live for when you have fun and you enjoy each other's company and you're snuggling on the couch and you're watching a movie. Some people live for venting to the love of their life. So their play, their praise, oh, I had a bad day at work. Oh, my mom's being mean. My kids aren't being nice. The house is a disaster. Life just isn't going, because we get into this negative spiral. I'm just as guilty as everybody else. I mean, it's been a trying couple of months for me with some family stuff going on and then trying to figure out something on my own. And, you know, then getting shocked with some things that have been said. It's just like, and then rough week with clients. I'm human. I do the same thing you do. But what I don't do is I don't blame my partner for ignoring me. I don't blame my partner and say they're ghosting me. I will literally message you and say, hey, stranger, it's been a while. And if you don't answer, I let it go. I go on and do something else. Sometimes I let a little bit out because I'm in a funk and I'll tell somebody this or a little bit of that. Sometimes it's easier to talk to a stranger than it is to talk to people around you. I know Hollywood is full of this. Yes, men. And yes, women. They surround celebrities and they hype these celebrities up so much that these celebrities get to the point that they think they can do anything, including controversial stuff that makes the public go, oh my gosh. But in reality, that is because they have somebody behind them going, yes, you could do this. Yes, you would win. Yes, you got this. Yes, this is easy. Yes, this is going to be fun. Yes, this part will be great for your career. Yes, support this charity. Yes, do this. And sometimes those yes people fail. But more often than not, they succeed. Why do they succeed? Not because they're telling the person yes all the time, because they're building that person's confidence. So if I'm yesing you and I'm building your confidence and you feel unstoppable, how are you going to feel about getting your specific person? How are you going to feel about marrying the love of your life? How are you going to feel about that job, your money, your car, your house, your friends, your family? You're going to feel like you are on top of the world. And you're going to walk around going, I'm on top of the world. Life is amazing. Life is wonderful. Everything just magically works out for me. Because you have a yes person. And that's why I don't like manifesting buddies. Because most of them aren't a yes person. If you're having a conversation with your manifesting buddy and that conversation would be something like this. Hey, what are you doing today? Oh, you know, I'm having a really bad day. So I'm sitting on the couch trying to figure out how to get out of this funk. And they're like, yes, you get out of this funk. Yes, we're going to go out and go for a walk. We're going to get up. We're going to do something. We're going to change this. Yes, we got this. We're going to change this. Steve Harvey said when he was unemployed and he didn't have to get up in the morning, that he had this guy who called him every morning at 5:30. And Steve would answer the phone groggily, good morning. And he'd be like, good morning, Steve. Today's gonna be a great day. Forget the guy's name. I do apologize to both Steve Harvey and that gentleman. But today's gonna be a great day. This went on for 30 days. This guy kept calling Steve and he asked him, why do you keep calling me and doing this? And he's like, well, if you do the same thing over and over again, you're going to get the same result. Nothing's going to change. So the 37th day, Steve woke up, answered that phone and said, good morning, this is Steve Harvey. Today's going to be a great day. It took 37 days for Steve to get it. 37 days. I shared a photo that took 3 years to capture. 3 years. You guys want your specific person right now. This person waited 3 years for this photo. It is the statue in Brazil with its arms out like this. And it looks like he's holding the moon. It took 3 years to get that picture. It took Steve Harvey 37 days to understand that he had to get up and start talking about today being a great day. How long is it going to take you to figure out that the more you say ghosting, third party, toxic, abusive, that is what you are going to continue to get? Most of you are not in a toxic relationship. Some of you are, and you need to rethink your relationship. You need to get out. You need to heal. You need to get a different perspective on relationships before you get back into a relationship with this person. You don't have to always heal you. You don't always have to do the inner work, but you have to change your story and how you play, praise, and pray with the person you want to be in a relationship with. That's exactly what you do with your best friend. That's exactly what you do with your work partner. You know, the work spouse, the work wife, the work husband. Like I've even seen, don't let them be, because if you let the work wife meet the whale wife, it's going to be chaos. Or if you let the work husband meet the work wife or the work husband, it's going to be chaos. It's only chaos because we're saying it's chaos. Like everything is going wrong that says you're going to go to a next level. But you have to say, oh my gosh, chaos is all around me. Now I'm getting raised up. You have to praise the chaos. Thank you for clearing the way so I can get what I want. Oh, chaos, I see you. I understand now that what you're doing is moving all this stuff out of my way so I can have my dream partner. I can have my dream job. Most people get up and go, I have to go to work today. I don't want to go to work today. I hate my job. My partner's not nice. Things aren't working out for me. We get up every day and start saying, you know what? I love my job. My job is so much fun. Going to work is fun. My partner and I have a great relationship. We have fun and romance. We play together, praise together, and we pray together. Talk about the way things are that you like. Most people want to hear drama, because if your drama is better than mine, I feel so much better about my life. But if your praise about your life is better, they don't want to hear it, because they think you're living the dream. Oh my gosh, you're doing all these wonderful, amazing things. Life is incredible. Well, theirs sucks. Now they feel worse. Really. And one person's definition of a word is not another person's definition of a word. So one person's love language isn't the same as another's. One person's happy isn't the same as another. I can be happy with chaos going all around me. And then something will hit and bam, I'm like, oh my gosh, maybe I'm not really happy. Maybe this isn't what happy is. I watched a video and they were saying, you got to be really upbeat, up, up, up. That's not my personality. Like, it really isn't my personality to sit there and be jumping up and down. Yay, yay, yay. It's not. I'm more quiet and reserved. I have a very amazing, fun side to my life. But that fun side is laughing and joking. It's not jumping up and down. It's not talking about the vortex being so exciting. When I walk around and I use the word excited, I get so hyped up, I feel like I'm on speed. Like, it's unnatural. But when I use the word amazing or incredible, that suits my personality more. So what are you praising your person with, and what words are you using? Listen to what they say and take their words. You did an incredible job. Jason Momoa uses the word incredible a lot. So if I were to say you're amazing, he would feel good about it. But if I were to say that was incredible what you just did, wow, I am so impressed, that was incredible, he's going to feel more from me than if I just said, oh, great job, so proud of you. Listen to what people say. Their words tell their story. And the way you play with them is how they tell you they enjoy life. The way you praise them is the words that they use, and you give them back to them. And the way you pray with them, that can be religiously or just by saying, thank you so much for being my amazing partner. Because now you're telling them and you're telling God or the universe or the vortex or the energy, whatever you want to call it. But play, praise, and pray, the three P's, is what truly makes an amazing relationship. I love you guys. You have an absolutely positively amazing day. I think I'm going to change things up a little bit and start doing videos Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday, so that I actually do get a full day off on Friday. So going forward, Sunday, Tuesday, Thursdays are going to be my YouTube video days and social media posts Sunday through Thursday. Fridays and Saturdays are still my days off. I do leave a week and day open for people who can't fit into my schedule during the week due to work, school, family activities that you might have going on. I love you. Have an absolutely positively amazing day. And if you've gotten this far in the video, you know the drill. We're so excited. Jason made that post. Travis got the donor and he is cured. If you want to be the match, you can check out the link in the description below. Whenever you click a link, make sure that you know where you're going and don't be conned. I do have bethematch.org in my description. If you're unsure, please go to Google and you can help save somebody's life. And as always, leave me a comment and let me know how I am drastically changing your life for the better.